He'll stall out to play it, and oh, he nearly gave one away. He chased it after he turned it over, and somehow Matt Zuccarello missed the yawning net. Leeson for the Ducks tries to go rink wide. Doesn't have to go through too many defenders. Klingberg keeps it in, and the first save of the game for Fleury is off the blocker. Finally intercepted down low by Shattenkirk, who rims it around, and it's kept in at the line by Steele. Kaprizov, room in the middle, and a good save with a blocker by Dostal.
Take a look at Kirill Kaprizov in the middle of the ice, and a real good read by Dostal. See how aggressive.
Tracked down by Matt Boldy. Just throws it back out center ice. Boldy, former Boston College Eagle, gets it ahead at center. Goudreau skates into it. Another save by Dostal as he steers that one away. Frederick Goudreau changing directions down low, sends it around. Up steps Jacob Middleton from the point. His point covered by Boldy, who throws it towards the net. Never got through. Boldy gets it back, hands it off. Goudreau turned away by Dostal. Oh,
great stop of that goal crease. And then Matt Boldy, who's a real good-looking young.
Apparently got a touch on it. No icing as it comes deep into the Anaheim zone. Connor Dewar gets it back to the line. Dumba let it go, waiting for a little redirect as Shaw did a drive by, but it went right on Dostal. Shaw keeps it alive, trying to find a shooting lane as Dumba, but he turns it over, and Benoit gets it ahead for Silverberg. Jacob across the line drops it off. Petrano mishandled it, got it on net from distance. Little backhand feed into the middle of the ice, and it's big Jordan Greenway, all 6'6" of him, who sends it out, and that one's off the goal post on a quick one-timer from Dumba.
Everson was saying the last five or six games that they've really become more active. Thinks you have to.
Kulikov turns it over, a chance for Eriksson Ek. Now it comes out to Addison at the right point. Got swatted away, possible three on two as Leeson leads the rush the other way. Strom is the trailer, sends it over. Zegras off the goal post.
Oh, what a stop on the rebound by Fleury. He got that off the post. The rebound came out. The Ducks haven't put a lot of pressure on him, but when this puck comes across to Zegras, it's off the post. The rebound comes out. Ryan Strome thinks he's got a wide open. And look at this left leg stop by Marc-Andre Fleury.
Goudreau lets one go, and good screen in front, but missed the mark. Merrill keeps it in at the left point for the Wild. Boldy behind the net. 11 goals on the year for the second year man. He got it right on net. Just over two to go in the period as Addison gives it right back. Zuccarello fires it off the shoulder of Dostal, who shrugs that one away.
He says, we really haven't strung together a full 60 minutes, and been a big topic of conversation inside that Wild locker room.
Terry drops down, gets a piece of it, and Zegras is off to the races. Fowler trying to join the rush to make it a 3-on-2. Fourth man in, coming late right down the slot is Terry, fought off by Fleury.
Yeah, that's a big stop by Marc-Andre Fleury. Fowler's going to join the rush, so the Ducks have two forwards and a D on the rush, with another forward, Terry, coming in late, and you can see Cam Fowler does a great job there. He drives that center lane, he pulls some people with him, and that's what creates the space for Terry.
Wild bring it out of the zone. Kaprizov with room through center. Now pulls up and turns it over. Mason McTavish on a breakaway. Out comes Fleury. McTavish scores!
Turns this puck over at the blue line. He's under pressure from Fowler. And look up, see how he puts the puck ahead of him? He doesn't want to stick handle with it. Lose a little bit of speed. Risk being caught. Pokes it in front, then brings it into the wheelhouse, and he was looking five hole all the way. Great finish.
Klingberg back for Terry. Had a little trouble with it, but he gains control now across the top of the zone. Makes a move in behind the net, the wraparound, and Fleury got across.
That's a great stop.
Klingberg's shot is deflected out of play. Troy Terry off to a great start, and well, he made a bid to make it 2-0, didn't he, Brian?
Oh, boy, what a nice move. See him tuck that puck around Sam Steele, and then he goes for the wraparound here, and Marc-Andre Fleury.
Wild regroup, and this is Matt Boldy. Boldy across the line, releases on the puck, and out comes Dostal to kick it away. In front of the net, Silverberg, time and space as Spurgeon's out of the box. Great pass ahead, shorthanded breakaway, and Fleury makes the save on Carrick. He left it laying around, and Boldy's there to clean it up. While killing a penalty, they nearly doubled their lead. Look at that pass by Silverberg. Carrick unable to foil Fleury. As the puck goes the other way, the Wild dump it in pursuit. Mason Shaw leaves it for Duehr. Tried to get it in front for Reeves. That one bounces away. Connor Duehr keeps it alive and scores. Oh, he turns off the boards and threw it through traffic. Dostal never saw it. We are tied.
It comes out of nowhere. Bully just screens Dostal, but boy, this is a very fortunate turn of events in favor of the Wild. Watch this. He's going to throw it, spin, throw it at the net. I think it does touch Nathan Beaulieu and changes direction.
Yep.
Goes off that right glove, I think, of Beaulieu and then up into the top corner.
Back around to Addison on the right side. Puts it down low. Erickson Ek had a couple of cracks at it right in the crease. And Dostal kept it out, and this one blocked to center ice. Of course, it's the second of back-to-backs for Anaheim, and the third period of those typically, at times, will expose a tired hockey club. And in comes Kaprizov, one times it right off the faceoff. 18-and-a-half-minute game now, tied at one as Greenway storms in, goes wide on the left side, uses his long reach, tried to stuff it, Dostal got across to the far post. It was Hartman who laid down in front of that.
Yeah, it was.
Chases the other way.
Yeah, I think he saves a goal. That's a great play by Hartman.
Kulikov back in his own zone. Can't clear past Boldy. Boldy off the glove of Dostal and in.
Hartman to the rescue with a sliding block. And then a turnover by Boldy. Knocks that puck out of midair. Pulls it into his wheelhouse. And it's off the thumb of the glove of Dostal. And up into the top corner. Now, how about how Kaprizov was skating? You know, he gets those feet at 10-2 to protect that puck and makes a blind pass right to Zuccarello.
Addison again across the top. He'll just tee it up and he scores! Joel Eriksson Ek, I believe, tips it in front. It's 3-1.
Yeah, judging by the reaction, I think you're right, John. Tougher on the goaltender. Watch in the middle of your screen. There's Eriksson Ek. He's right at the hash marks. And here comes the shot. And there's the redirect. And it's perfect. Right up into the top corner. The puck's coming in about 2 feet high and it ends up about 3.5 feet high. And no chance for Dostal. The Wild power play. It almost seemed inevitable, didn't it?
Pass intended for Hartman. Disrupted by Benoit, but kept at the line by Spurgeon. Cross for Steele. He looks up, takes the shot. Dostal fights it off. It's loose at the top of his crease, and he covers up.
Yeah, nice little play. Dostal, you know, when you know a player is there and he's going to try and redirect the puck, you got to get as close to his stick blade as you can so that he can't, you know, tip it up and over your arms. Get down, get tight to him, build that wall in front of him, and Dostal does a good job of that.
Klingberg gets it back. Boldy steps into him. And Boldy able to carry it across the line. He'll feed it across. Zuccarello gets to it and keeps his scoring. It's Hartman who puts it into the empty net. And the Wild have a 4-1 lead.
Trouble back at the point. And Boldy with a pretty good healthy hack there on the stick of Klingberg helped create that turnover. And Hartman, it don't get any easier than that.
Clock winds down, the final ticks, and the Minnesota Wild have a 6-game winning streak as the Ducks open the homestand with a 4-1 setback at the hands of Marc-Andre Fleury.